Hello, today we are going to see an experiment from Practical Botany, Paper 8, Determination the rate of photosynthesis at different wavelength of light. Aim of the experiment is to study the rate of photosynthesis at different wavelength of light using an apparatus called Wilmot's bubbler. The material required for the experiment are conical flask of 100 ml capacity, water reservoir tube, which you can also see in Ganox photometer, one hold rubber cork which is tightly fixed to the conical flask, a disposable dropper where the lower portion is cut off and the upper portion is retained, hydrilla plant, cellophane color paper, where here we only use three color, red, green and blue. Procedure: take the rubber cork and insert the bubbler to the lower portion of the cork, like this. Take the water reservoir tube and insert to the upper portion of the rubber cork. Tightly assemble the apparatus. After the assemble, you can see upper portion as the water tube, cork and the bubbler. Once the assemble is completed, take the hydrilla plant and cut the lower portion of the stem with the help of scissor. Insert the cut portion of the stem into the bubbler. Take the conical flask with water and 1% sodium bicarbonate solution, which serve as the carbon source for the photosynthesis. Add still more water and avoid the formation of air bubble inside the conical flask. And add water to the water reservoir tube also. It is the diagram of Wilmot's bubbler, where you can see inside the conical flask hydrilla plant and upper water reservoir where air bubble formation can be seen. Here is the experimental setup. We count the number of air bubble formation for the control, which is white light source, count the number of air bubbles evolved per 1 minute of time interval. Comment your answer in the comment section for number of air bubbles evolved per 1 minute. The second setup is, it is a monochromatic light, red light wavelength of 620 to 750 nanometer. Here we count the number of air bubbles evolved per 1 minute. Observe and comment your answer in the comment section below. The third setup, which is a monochromatic light of blue light wavelength 450 to 495. Nanometer. Observe the number of air bubbles evolved per 1 minute. And submit your answer and observation in the comment section. The fourth and final setup is green color light of wavelength 495 to 570 nanometer. Here, the air bubble formation is very less, sometimes it is nil. You can also try this experiment by simply wrapping the cellophane colored paper to the conical flask. Observation. Tabulate your result and observation taking 3 trials and take the average value and comment your result. Comments. Under the normal light, that is control, the plant shows a definite rate of photosynthesis because the pigment were active in photosynthesis. Observe the respective wavelength. These wavelength being most effective, the rate of photosynthesis is almost maximum if other factors are also favorable. In the red wavelength, the rate of photosynthesis is maximum. The wavelength 670 nanometer is known to be maximally effective one for photosynthesis. In the blue wavelength, the rate of photosynthesis is also maximum, but it is always lesser than that of red. In the green wavelength, the rate of photosynthesis is practically zero or very less in this region. This is because the chlorophylls reflects green wavelength. Conclusion: rate of photosynthesis is very high in multichromatic light, that is white color. In monochromatic light, the rate of photosynthesis is more in red light, while it decreases in green light. Thank you.